Another way to add more power to your knowledge base is to leverage live queries. This feature might or might not exist natively in your tool for Tart, but there might be ways to add support through extensions. This is the case for Obsidian, where the Dataview plugin does just that. Using live queries, you can find what you need when you need it. You can leverage the metadata and tags on your nodes, but also the file creation modification dates. I'm going to show you a few examples. Using the Dataview plugin in Obsidian, you can query your nodes using different ways. So you can query your nodes based on tags, based on their location, based on their metadata. You can also create lists and tables with the results. What is interesting about Dataview queries is that the results are dynamic. So if you add a new node to your system and a query surface that node, then it will appear in the results. Dataview queries are written using a specific syntax. In this case, it starts with backtails, then the Dataview keyword, and then you can write the query itself. So in this case, I'm creating a list from all of the nodes that I have tag quotes and the tag PKM. And I sort the result based on the file name in ascending order. And so if I get out of this context, you can see the results of the query. And now if I go about and create a new node having those two tags, such as this one, so you can see that it has PKM and quotes, the new node would appear in the results list. In this second example, I'm querying all of the nodes that are located in a specific folder. So in this case, meta nodes that are about maintenance of my system. And I limit the number of results to 5. So there are only 3 in this case, but if I further limit the results of that query, we can see that it reflects automatically on the relevant ones. And you can do truly advanced things using the Dataview plugin. So this is an example where the query is written using code. So if you are a programmer, then you can do amazing things with it. And so in this case, I'm creating a list of all of the pages, and I sort those by the file modification time in descending order. I limit the results to 5, and I include the link to the node. So if I add this query to a node, so it's written like this, again, backtails, but in this case, I'm going to use the JavaScript version of the queries. I include the query I want, and I end up with the backtails again. And now if we just look at the node, it surfaces the nodes that match the query. So here's one more example. In this case, I'm creating a table that includes as column the modification time that I call updated on. I search everywhere in the knowledge base and I limit the results to the nodes that don't have any incoming links, any outgoing links and node tags. And also I exclude the orphans from the list. And finally, I sort by modification time descending. And so this gives me a list of orphan nodes in my system. Some of those might be problematic, some of those not, but it's a good way to maintain my system. So using such queries, you can implement maintenance systems where you can find out which nodes should maybe be looked at. Here's another one. So it's a more advanced example. Again, it's actually programming. I'm creating a function that is able to list file name issues. It uses the Dataview plugin to find all of the nodes, and it groups those by the file name to lowercase. And for each group, it tries to find other nodes that have the same name. And then I call the function that I just created, passing it to the Dataview plugin. And now if we check the results of that query, you can see that I get a list of duplicate nodes in my system. And those are clearly ones that I should be looking at because I don't want to have duplicates. Interestingly, using the Dataview plugin, you can also explore your nodes randomly. So in this case, I'm using the math.random function to list a certain number of nodes randomly on the knowledge base. And so here I get a list of random nodes in my system. Another use case for the Dataview plugin is including queries inside of your daily nodes. In this example, I'm querying all of the nodes in my system that have the same date, but from a different year. And in this case, I surfaced 3 nodes that I had in previous years. Notice that the query was written in a different way. I will come back to this later. And this is another set of examples that I have in my knowledge base. So I have this home node that I can quickly open using this plugin. And here I have a list of random nodes, a list of fleeting nodes, things that are in my knowledge inbox, recent quotes that I've captured, and things like that. And all of those are actually based on Dataview queries. So if we take a look at the source code behind that node, you can see that I have different queries for each of the parts. So my knowledge inbox, the recent quotes, so having the quotes tag, those in a certain location in my knowledge base, others having different tags, and more. So I have many examples here. And here I also have a set of data view queries. Those are written using a shorter syntax, in this case, just a back tilde and the expression. And I use those to extract statistics from my knowledge base. So if we look at that one, you can see that we have the stats being extracted by the data view plugin. And I also use such queries to maintain my maps of content automatically. I have this query that lists all of the nodes in my system. I have the PKM tag and that have been published. And so I don't have to maintain those manually. That's another benefit of using Dataview and the Dataview Serializer plugin that I'm using here. Now, just a quick note about this specific syntax. So as I mentioned, this is not the Dataview plugin, but actually a plugin that I've built on top of it that is called the Dataview Serializer. And the idea behind that one is that when a query is detected by the plugin, it will actually generate the list of results. But if I look at this file on my file system, I will find those links. And this is a big difference with normal Dataview queries, because when you are using the normal syntax for the Dataview plugin, so using this, for instance, with the three back tilts, like this with the query, if you do this, then within Obsidian, you will see the results. But if you open your notes outside of Obsidian, so using any text editor, what you will see is actually this and not the results. And so this is the big difference between those two. And the reason why I created this is first so that my notes remain useful even if the Dataview plugin disappears. So those links are there and will remain there. But also, if I publish my notes on the web, I will actually have the links available. And this does not work currently with the Dataview plugin. And so if we go here and look for my PKM map of content, you will see that the links are actually there. And this wouldn't be the case if I was using the normal Dataview plugin queries.